Hello.
Okay. So first time ko palang haharap dito sa mga music ministry na to, no? Yes, and then for the other people also na who will see me preach, and medyo importante itong preaching na to, no? Kasi it's a practicum. Now, it's a practicum. I will explain what will happen later. Ano mangyayari mamaya, but I just wish na you can silence phones para hindi ma-capture ng ating videographer na si Sistang who's doing it today. And then before that, we will also be coinciding a simultaneous audiences. Ating mga Highway 19 Oman Summit participants! Can you just give a hand to them, huh? Nakikinig sila ngayon, and they are broadcasting live also, and we are also broadcasting live to Oman, so they can see us, and we are in spirit with them. So I know it's a very successful summit, and we've seen the videos. Hi there, Pastor Ryan, Pastor Ray, Sister MJ, Sister Jen, Brother Don, we miss you here in the GWF. So can I just request all to just stand up, to just reflect how are we going to, there's a pressure for Misala, for all of us to really speak her language, and of course the international language of English. We are going to talk about worshiping God the right way. This is the topic for today's sermon, and it's found in the 1 Corinthians chapter 14, verse 20-33. This is a continuation of what Pastor Ryan sermon last week. And if you were here, and I was not here, I was able to watch his video, and I will just continue his talk about 1 Corinthians. So before that, before we pray, may I just request all of you, basa ba? Kaya? Okay, before we read it, let's just bow our head and let's ask for a quick reflection and adoration from God. Lord, dear God, we thank you more than enough, Panginoon. We are here to really resurrect our faith with you, God. Thank you for using me as a vessel, God. Thank you for coming into my life and sharing all these thoughts and equipping the church members of the GWF Rock community who are present here in the church and who are also live on stream, who are going to witness your preaching and your words, God. We allow the embrace. We thank you for all the immersions that we are going to do with your words, God. Allow us to learn from it. Allow us to reflect. And most of all, allow us to apply, O Lord, all the lessons that you are going to tell us, all the instructions, and all the gospel and the words that you're going to inspire in our lives, O God. We thank you enough, and we thank you for all the brothers and sisters that we have also in Oman, Lord, doing a Highway 19 Summit. We pray for the success and the continued success of what they're doing as we simultaneously have them in spirit, O God. So let us all say, Amen, Panginoon, Amen. You can all sit down. I request you to all sit down. So I was just explaining a while ago, why is this important, okay? Because as you may all know, I am halfway through the Bachelor of Arts in Theology course that we are taking each Friday for the GWF RAC membership with the Laytorgo Seminary. Can you believe it? Nagse-seminary po ako. Even myself, I cannot believe it. But we are attending our almost 50% of the lessons now. And what I can just say, it's not easy. It's not easy po really digging so much to the gospel of words of God, because there's no room for error. Yan yung aming kinatatakutan, no? the way we preach, the way we stand here, and mostly the Bible study leaders as well, and the preachers and the exhorters. That's the most overwhelming part of holding the Bible, being assigned a topic to render and to exhort, and most of all, not to misinterpret the word. And can you imagine our youngest exhorter, Sister Ajit, accepting the challenge of exhortation? And I myself have goosebumps every time I open the Bible and dig into it. What else? To a 14-year-old, a grade 8 student. But what's the best thing about learning and digging into the words of God is that the revelations. Okay, that's what I'm going to focus on today as we continue Pastor Ryan's 1 Corinthians topic of this day. So may I just flash it? Medyo nakawala ang ating PowerPoint. Galaw-galaw faith dun sa HDMI. So instead of a clicker, this is my best friend. Okay? Because this been very useful for 2 years of my teaching life, because I rarely right now on smart board or whiteboard, but I mostly type using an electronic keyboard, no, for this thing. So we will just request Sister Faith to just use the PowerPoint from her phone or from Facebook that she copied. So let's just check. So technical problems happen, but if this happens, you just pray that it will not distract you. So I think it's working now. Yeah, will you be able to read with me? So I think we can start reading at the count of 1, 2, 3. Let's start.
Brothers and sisters, stop being like children in regard to being lowly in hearts, but in the law and spirit,
with other tongues,
foreigners, as to these people, but they will not listen
to me, says the Lord. Tongues.
Not for believers, but for unbelievers. But for unbelievers.
So if the whole church
comes together and everyone speaks in tongues, and whoever is for unbelievers from now, they will not say that you are of your mind.
Two more slides.
What if they shall say, brothers and sisters, when you come together, each of you has a name, or a word of instruction, or a revelation, a tongue, or an interpretation. Everything must be done so that the church may be built up. If anyone speaks in the tongue, two or at most three should speak one at a time, and someone must interpret. If there is no interpreter, the speaker should keep quiet in the church and speak to himself and to God.
Last slide.
Two or three prophets should speak, and the other should take carefully what he says. And if your revelation comes to someone who is sitting down, the first speaker should stop. For you have all prophesied, and returns with everyone who is instructed and encouraged. The spirits of prophets are subject to the control of prophets. For God is not the God of disorder, but of peace, as all the congregations of the Lord's people.
Hallelujah. It's a little bit lengthy, but I will only have 3 points for you to remember. Again, the topic that we are discussing for today is how do we worship God the most rightful way? And I think it's clear to me, Salah, right? That question, of course, and how are we going to really serve our greatest worship to God? Okay, that's last week's points. Let's just quickly identify some of the highlights of Pastor Brian's topic last week on how to choose to edify the church. Again, this is an extension. This is a continuation of the first Christian topic that he had last time. So he was talking most about the use of the gift of tongue. And the gift of tongue, according to him, I was not here last week, but I got from his Facebook Live video was that it's a gift that allows members to interpret the holiness of the words of God. Not all of us have this. But once you have this, you fully use it to build up the church. The church godliness, the church faithfulness, and the gracefulness of God. He also mentions there that they need to use the book of prophecy. More than the gift of tongue, the gift of prophecy. The gift of prophecy is given to some people who will be able to really predict things that may happen the way Jesus Christ did it before, but it's only on this gift that we interpret this reflection that's so good that it becomes a good thing for the church. And lastly, to use to edify the church by working in unity. If we don't work in unity, according to him, we are not edifying the works of God, because if wata-wata, if we are in group, we are not in a solid union of one goal, this will not give us a clarity of praising Him. Let's review the book of Corinthians. Okay. This was supposed to be Pastor Reyes, but they are in Oman right now doing what we call as an International Summit of Highway 19. It's a mission, universal mission for the God's Way Fellowship to spread the words of God in all corners of the world. Do you still remember the Great Commission? And what is the Great Commission? To spread the gospel of the Lord in all nations. Not only through Christians, not only through Christians, but to all works in all this universe. If we can manage to go to the heavenly planets or outside the earth, maybe in the future, this might be possible. So kung mapansin nyo, medyo mahaba-haba yan na yung inassign sa akin ni Pastor. We will try to put it into three points para hindi tayo mahirapan. But let's just a quick recap. How many are attending a regular Sunday church? Please raise your hand. Again, can I just ask, what book are we studying?
First Corinthians.
Good. We have a great student here who's always present, who always understands. But do you truly understand what the book is all about? Okay. Yan yung isa sa ating context review, no? How many here came only today? Or from the returnees, we have returnees, and we have some people who may have missed some Sunday gospels, but we are, or you are already here. We have our couple there, of course, Brother Pao and Sis, okay, Araceli. We are in the book series of 1 Corinthians. So what this book is all about, context review, Todo. We are doing a context review so that every time or every Sunday that you come here, you don't miss the lesson. And personally, as a teacher, because I personally teach, this is one way of checking the understanding or comprehension of the students, of our attendees, of our believers, if they remember what they learned from last week's letter of Paul to Corinth. Huwag natin kalimutan that we are studying in 1 Corinthians, it's a love letter. Isa po yung sulat before Paul died and before Paul actually left the earth. When he was in jail, sinulat niya pa yan sa loob ng kulungan, ng prison cell, when he was just incarcerated for 10 years, no? And this was his love letter to the people of Corinth. Okay? So, another context review. So, this actual letter was his public ministry. Hindi yan mini-minister sa Jerusalem, not even in Galilee, not even in Israel. He was on a search for a 3-year missions to the country of Greece. So siguro, you will hear Pastor Ray or Pastor Ryan giving all of us that lesson. But we must not forget that these lessons on the story of Paul is a letter for the Greeks, for the Romans. Because he was criticizing them. He was totally on criticism sa mga mali of that time. Then, let's one more bago tayo pumunta sa 3 points natin. 3 years po siyang nagministro sa country of Greece, which is called Greece now, in the places or cities and locations of Corinth, Ephesus. Again, this was not in Israel, but in his 3 years ministry. Okay, and we're talking particularly of the book of 1 Corinthians. Ha? Huwag po tayong malilito. We will not be confused about this. Okay. I was surprised 2 days ago nung maintindihan ko to that the Apostle Paul did not actually meet Christ face to face. Apostle Paul or Saint Paul, as they call it in some of the religious organization, they did not have the chance to have a face-to-face encounter with Jesus Christ. He only heard about Jesus Christ when he started visiting and studying about Him. Wala ho si Apostle Paul doon sa 12 Last Supper saints. Ha? Wala ho siya doon. He doesn't belong to any of those 12 people who are in the Last Supper.
Disciples.
Okay, with the disciples that he, sister was talking about, hindi ho siya included doon. So, but the question here now, what made him interested to gospel about the works of Jesus Christ? Yan natin ang aalamin maya-maya. And then lastly, okay. So, pakibasa nga po kung what caused his death. Can we just read bullet and checklist number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Let's all read together. Paul died because of the beheading due to the Roman Emperor Nero because of persecution. So, we know already that to be able to stand ground of gospeling and talking about Jesus Christ, your life is at stake. And we're talking of 56 AD century. 56 years after the death of Christ, Paul already is ministering, and the cost of this ministry, his own life. Yung pagkamatay ng kanyang buhay, he was in sentence for spreading wrong teachings about, of course, the Bible. He was kidnapped by the Romans. He was sentenced to death. For 10 years, ikinulong siya. And his final judgment was guillotine, pagputol po ng kanyang ulo. Another fun fact na maybe we are not aware of, but that's Paul. That's the what we call yung martyrdom of Saint Paul or Apostle Paul. And luckily, who has Netflix here? Who is subscribed to Netflix? So we are just so lucky. Okay. Bakit? Because the life of Paul is actually in Netflix. I also discovered this only last week, that his life story is actually made into a full-length film. Actually, kung matatandaan niyo po, there is a movie by Mel Gibson called The Passion of Christ. And he was the Christ in that film, Jim Caviezel. And he produced another film called Paul the Apostle of Christ. It was filmed 2 years ago. If you have Netflix or if you have YouTube, please, I encourage you to watch this because it talks about the persecution of Paul's life for 10 years. During the times when he was actively professing his faith to win Jesus Christ. So let's just watch 2 minutes of the clip of what his life is all about. Slide na mo, Paul. Tatayo doon. Slideshow. And mag-slideshow muna tayo, no? Why is it important to know about the life of Paul? So that you know the value of what his gospel is talking about the people of Corinth. So, slide number dun sa bandang photo ng Paul. Slide 6. Dito ba na 6? Dahil baba pa. So, baba nyo lang and let's just go and go down. Kasi I can control here and they can control here also. So, start to talk again para dyan yung ma-control. So, nandun? Kaya? Nandang? So, we are experiencing this and we might think na maybe distraction to ng kaaway because we are nearly going to that point of the gospel. So, sige lang, let's be patient and maikukwento ko lang sa buhay ni Paul. It was not easy. Nung pinanood ko yung pelikula, he belonged to the life of the silver spoon. Mayaman nung siyang ipinangala. He is not even belonging. Click lang yung enable content. Ayan, and then slideshow. Okay, tapos punta tayo dun sa yes. Backward. Sige, baba. Ayan. Punta ka sa gitna. I-click that. Let's play this one. So, and I think it will play now.
Luke sent a message to all those that follow our Lord Jesus Christ. There is a terrible evil in the world. Darkness is spreading. Suffering persecution, faith is being tested. I know you question your way, but I've come to know to find power, to write his story, to bring hope, to bring light into this present darkness, and to remind us all how God changed the name from man, who changed the history of the world. Trust in God.
this Christians.
I am concerned with these Christians.
We can't get this out wrong. It seems that we are plotting an escape.
That kind of world, I send it to whatever country you want.
If you have chance to go to YouTube, it's free on YouTube. Libre lang din siya sa YouTube. So you can also check it. It will really give you a glimpse about the life of His eminence, the story of Apostle Paul. So let's just go back to the slide. See straight. So, two laptops now are freezing. My laptop froze, and so I think this is going to work now. Yeah, it's working from here, context review, okay. So now, you saw the film, you saw the characters of the Romans trying to put a hard life on Paul. But now, we are so lucky today that we can read all these testaments of love of Paul, yung sinakripisyo niya sa buhay niya, that we can read it in 1 Corinthians. And that is what my context of lessons are going to go. So, worshiping God the right way, no? Let's just put it down into context again that Paul was talking not to us now, huh? He was referring to his letter to the Corinth. The Corinthians, the Greek people who he thinks do not praise God in the most rightful way. So let's just remember that context. When we say, how do we worship God the most rightful ways? Maybe we have opinions today that we feel are considered rightful. But let's go to the context of Apostle Paul. Let's not be confused about that. Let's separate what this godful or godly and rightful ways of how he felt the Corinth people or the Greek people are not worshiping God in the most rightful way. So I have 3 points here that we can find in verses 20-25, verses 26-28, and 29-33. I will also be teaching you about what we call is acronymic learning. Now, ito yung B man, not children. Focus on B, on M, on N, and C. B men, not children. So yan yung kanyang first advice. The question that we're answering here, according to the understanding of Sister, siguro si Sister Rodeline, no? The question that she also wants to know is that, what is Paul's suggestion on how we praise and worship God the rightful way? There are 3 suggestions. First suggestion, that's one. Second suggestion, and edification is a very important word because this is something that we are doing in the modern church right now. I will explain that later in my point number 2. Okay, now what are the keys to worshiping God the right way? So, are you ready to delve into the 3 points? Be men, not children. So, Paul was talking in here. He was explaining to the people who may listen or who may find to be very interesting about being men and not children. No? In his very long letter, sa pagkahaba-haba ng kanyang sulat, he just summarized these points into three. Why becoming men and not children? I remember one lesson made by Sister Aggie in her exhortation. I will never forget that. When you mentioned before about how can we enter heaven, God used children in their faith to be able to really have that faith-like and obedient-like belief as children. Because comparing men to children, they have different personalities. But again, Paul was talking here about his notice, his criticism, his bad thoughts about why people of Greece are praising God in a wrong way. So maybe he was noticing upon walking in his ministries and upon walking for 3 years in Greece that something might be not good. And he noticed this and he observed this because, come on, 3 years. I mean, if I send you a sister, like for example, if I send Joey to study the TikTok behavior of people living in Greece, so it's only but obvious that for the 3 years, he will be able to learn and observe what is the core personalities of the people living in that country, right? So just imagine Paul being so critical about his mission. So he felt that the people in Greece are not mature enough. That's why he said they are not men, but doing and practicing as children. According to him, first, what did he notice about the immaturity of believers in Greece and Ephesus? Your thoughts. Okay, because maybe their misbehavior, their identification or the thoughts of praising God is just so childlike. Masyadong very immature. How they behave, how they praise, and how they communicate their worship to God. So that's why he was saying, be mature. Number two, proclaim the Spirit of God even to unbelievers. Okay. This is 56 AD Greece. Patay na ang Diyos. Jesus already was crucified, resurrected, and after 56 years, people have been following him. There were already minimum or fewer amount of people who followed him. Not only in Galilee, not only in Israel, not only in Jerusalem, but the outskirts, yung mga nearby countries like Assyria, Syria, Persia, Babylonia, and then of course yung pinuntahan nga ni St. Paul, which is yung Greece. So he noticed that there are unbelievers who are already praising God, but the wrong way. So, but what was his advice to us? To proclaim into the Spirit of God, even for those that are not part of our congregation. No? Mahalaga yun that we do not choose who to gospel. Because they feel and we feel like faith and salvation are for all, not only for individual people. Ngayon, pangatlo, sinabi niya dyan. Okay, as believers, celebrate the unity so that they can witness them. So we don't have first-time visitors here, right? Okay, but every time there will be first-time visitors, like, what's your name? Si Sister Cherry?
Stephanie po.
Si Sister Stephanie. This is your third week, second week. So, try to notice her, no? She is observing all of us. And I feel that when she sees us and when she observes us, she does not only witness, or she's not only observing how we talk, how we joke, or how we move, or how we communicate to each other, but I'm sure you are also watching us carefully on how we praise. So I think that's very important, because in your 2 weeks of attending the GWF Rock community, there's form of impression already. I've been here for, this is my third year. Miss Sala is attending the church for almost a couple of months. Sister is attending here the church for almost a month now. So we have all our form of impression that we should be very careful on how we celebrate these things to the non-believers, or the first-time visitor, or the repeaters, or the returnees. We celebrate with unity. I will explain this unity more, because that's very important. That's according to St. Paul. Ito tayo sa point number 2, edification. Okay. Edify is the main verb here. And according to that very long letter, if there's no edification, kapag walang edification, it's wrong. Kapag walang edification, there's nothing that God is being pleased. But what is edification now? Edification is the change or the improvement of the behavior, the personality, the progress of the emotions of people. But for spiritual or Christians like us, according to what we can define edification for Christians, change of heart. Change of heart. Kapag walang edify or change of heart into this point number 2, it's not godly. It's not worshiping God. So let's look into his suggestion. How many ministries do we have? Music, we have education ministry in the church, we have food ministry in the church. What else do we have in the church? We have the pulpit ministry, we have the finance ministry, and we have all other ministry. We have to thank Brother Lito for the gift of leadership for the music ministry, right? That's his contribution. Can you tell to yourself now, what do you contribute to the church? I contribute maybe my gift of knowledge. That's why I'm standing here in front of you, just making sure that I summarize and I keep this knowledge fresh for all of you. No? That's my contribution to the church. But how about the other members of the church? How about Stephanie? How about Sister Agnes? How about Sister Faith? How about the boys there who are talking and listening to us? Are they contributor also? So the question here now is, the word, it's an act to challenge you that to act and become a contributor for the church. Whatever your gift is, Pastor Ray was telling us that we have individual gifts. And some of us have the gift of cooking. So celebrate this, share it to the church, edify God with your own contribution of gift. Okay. Now that you know your gift, now that you can act to contribute the gift, what else is expected according to Apostle Paul? Make sure that this gift doesn't stay here. Make sure that the gift does not only stay in one position, that it's not progressive. Make sure that the gift, according to this word, and how do we know that we're building up the church? How do we know that we're building up the church? Is it because we have more members now?
compared last year, compares 2 years ago, does that answer the building up of the church? Again, let's go back to the point number one of edification, which is changing of hearts. Transformation po. Do natin yan mami-measure on how the church is being built by members being transformed. Huwag po natin kakalimutan yun. Next one, learn when to be quiet and when to speak. Now, some of us have the gift of communicating to people. But according to Apostle Paul, there is a guide for us, for the church to become more organized. And he said that learn to be quiet and learn when to speak. Timing ang kanyang tinutukoy dito. Timing in the sense that he wants us to speak when the right timing comes. So, when do we start not to speak? When the Holy Spirit tells us to use our ears. And that's the time we listen. Nakikinig po tayo into our pastors, our people who's testifying in front of here. Hindi mo madali to come here and really speak in front so that you'll be heard. That's not going to be easy. And I mean, for those who are singing in front of here, it takes a lot of practice. That's why you come here early. You're the earliest people in the music ministry to come here because you don't want to really mess up with the singing, with the playing of the instruments, and of course, with the worshiping of God. So point number two, what is the suggestion? What is the suggestion? Two things for edification, ha? So yan yung point number two natin na makikita sa verse 26 to 28. Ito yung mga detailed suggestion ni Apostle Paul as revealed by his letter. Okay? Last point, huli na. Before we conclude this and before we summarize all the points of our lessons for today. How do we worship God the right way? Okay. From his walk, according to the film na napanood ko, there were a lot of confusion in the place of Ephesus and in the place of Corinth. Kung nakita niyo sa trailer, may tao sa gilid sinusunog. Okay? Kung nakita niyo sa gilid, may mga nagtitinda. Kung nakita niyo sa gilid, may mga taong nag-aaway, naglalasingan. And this is not how God wants to be worshipped. Oh, kahit nandun sila sa simbahan, but people outside were just totally messing up worshiping God. Three suggestions. When I came here February, Sister Rose may not remember this, but my first visit of Praise and Worship Sunday was February 16, 2021. 2022. Nung una akong tumapak, not in front of this, but to enter the doors of the GWF Rock community. And I was welcomed by all with whole heart. And I noticed that they follow a sequence of program. Yung pala yung uso dito, that of course you start with prayer, you start with two songs, meron tayong testimonies, meron tayong sermon, meron tayong another songs, then may tithes and offering. And I feel this is what St. Paul was talking here. Order of manner. Just imagine kung papasok lang kayo dito, sasamba, sabay-sabay, kakanta, sabay-sabay, magsasalita, nothing is in control. Will that really rightfully worship God?
Of course, the answer is no. That's why he was saying to the people of Corinth, come on, hello, organize yourself. Have an orderly passion of praising and worshiping God. This is the only way you can really manage to get His attention and really look forward for His blessing if you are really making sure that you are serving Him right in an orderly fashion. Okay. May mga manghuhula ba tayo dito to interpret this literally? I don't think it's talking about the manghuhula, no? What is the meaning of prophecies here? Share your prophecies in turns. It was noted by Apostle Paul that people who have the gift of interpretation, people who are already knowledgeable to interpret his words, should share what they feel is considered to be useful for the church. And again, why Apostle Paul was telling all of this to the Corinth? So that they can build up, organize, and systematic churches at that part of the world. No, because they are praising, they always call God, holy grace of God, oh God, help us, oh God, but they're not doing it the orderly manner. So who did he instruct this to do? People who already have the knowledge or the prophecy. Because come on, it's already obvious. We have here pastors, we have here leaders in the church who have studied, who have already learned about ahead of us the interpretation and the words of God. So that's the only way we can do right now is to share it that would please God. Okay? Final point. There was once this pastor in Mindanao, in the Philippines, okay? One testament or one news that he spread in news that this blah, blah, blah is blah, blah, blah. All people believe it. But instead, I'm not saying the name of that, okay, big and controversial pastor back in the Philippines, but every time he says something in social media, people and Filipinos just buy it. Of course, maybe because he already had the gift of prophecy. But look at St. Paul's advice. When you prophesy, you do it in harmony, not in confusion. But this is the challenge for all of us believers now, because people who are gifted with the ability to communicate and speak, they are so good. Ang gagaling na po ng mga pastor, ang gagaling na po of these different religious leaders from other sects of community to convince people. Okay, but again, how do we define whether it's building up the church or not? This word. If it's solidifying a church to a harmonious relationship, now, that is worshiping God. Eh, ang sister, paano kung pinag-aaway-away? Paano if he's just planting things to really create confusion? And come on, this is the start of the downfall of many churches in the Philippines. And can you just say amen that we have God's way fellowship in here in the UAE who manages to really, we are gospel-based. Amen. We are gospel-based that your preachers are just so scared to misinterpret these words. That's why we really spend time to really read the text, study the text, research on the text, identify the text, reflect on the text, reread the text, so that we can just stand here giving you the most important prophecy that we can give. And that is not to totally make you, because if that feel makes you confused, that is the work of the devil. That is worshiping the devil. Okay, so ngayon po, let's summarize our points 1, 2, and 3. Again, let's look and answer the three questions that St. Paul is asking us. The question here, how do we worship God the most rightful way? Okay. Answer number 1. Can you just shout? According to St. Paul,
immature.
Immature.
Children.
Again,
women.
According to St. Paul,
women, not children.
Wow, that's good. So something that you learned today is the spiritual maturity of this one. So that's why I was saying to you to please remember that text. Okay, are you ready for number 2? Yung mga Alibaba dyan, yung mga kumukuha sa kodigo. Patay na. Okay, be men, not, okay,
children.
Suggestion number 2, recommendation number 2 from our Apostle Paul.
Do things for edification.
I will not call sister, no, because may kodigo. Ajik!
Do things for edification.
Again, church!
Do things for edification.
One more time, church!
Do things for edification.
So again, edification keywords. Tuwa-tuwa siya na nangungkati ko siya, eh. Sis, no, but I mean, this is part of how to review you, no? If this is a real class, kasunod na ito, quiz na, guys. No, kung if you are really attending my class, I'll be giving you a quick quiz right away. But again, how do we say and how do we define edification? Again, it will not edify you or it will not edify the church if there's no change of heart. Never forget that. Transformation, change of heart, all of these things. If that is not happening to you weekly, stop attending. You don't have the right to worship God or to ask forgiveness or to ask if each week no changing of heart is happening. The sad thing here is that sometimes people do it, the next day they commit sins. But the best thing about God is that His mercy is everlasting. You do it, you seek forgiveness. You do your best to edify Him and you turn 180 degrees. This was very classic to the suggestion of Pastor Ray each time he baptized us. 180 degrees. Malinaw na malinaw na malinaw. Clear as eyes. Commit sin. Seek your heart. Transform your heart. And make sure that it goes and it's being done for edification. Last point.
Worship God the right way.
Wow! Again, one more!
Worship God the right way.
Point number 1.
Even as
point number 2.
Looking for education.
And point number 3.
Worship God the right way.
So that is the suggestion of Paul that is still considered. It is the core of the church that we are serving today, you know? So that's why this is really so important na hindi niyo yan makalimutan when you go out of this house of worship right now. So may I just request all of you again a summary or the conclusion of what we have learned today. At the count of 1, two, three. Again, wait. Medyo maliit. One, two, three.
Today's sermon tells us how Paul recommends three points to worship God the right way. First, we should all mature with our faith in God. Second, also Paul suggests doing things for the edification of His kingdom. Finally, worship the Lord with unity, harmony, and not in confusion. I promise to help the church in building up more than organization to help me God.
So, okay, that ends. Walang quiz class. No quiz. Totally no quiz. And that concludes our, part of the sermon for today. And we don't have any new members for newcomers, right? So may I just call all to please ready yourself and your tithes and offerings as we call Sister, who's doing tithes and offering for today? Sister Rose.
Thank you.